afternoon, Daville Elementary School, and welcome back to another great broadcast of TNN Tiger News Network. Have a great show for you today. First of all, we have a book fair going on. Miss Knight has a couple of videos that she wants me to show. I'm going to show you those videos real quick. But guys, if you have not been to that book fair, make sure you get that. Parents, if you didn't know anything about the book fair, have a book fair going on. Going to show you a quick video of the book fair, some things that's just kind of telling you a little bit about the book fair. And then we have two special guests on today, Ms. Miller and Mr. Chamness, going to talk to you a little bit about ACAP. Let's go ahead and get over to the book fair. There you have it. Guys, why not go to the book fair? All right, let's go ahead and get over to Ms. Miller and Mr. Chamness.
Hey, DES parents and students, it's wonderful to be with you all.
Glad to have you tonight and watching the show today.
Parent night tonight will be very exciting. In grades kindergarten and first grade, your parents will be able to see what a day in your life in kindergarten and first grade is like, what you go through during reading and math instruction, and how they can help you at home to become a better reader or a better math student. And in second through sixth grade, we will be focusing on ACAP and how you can ace the ACAP. Speaking of the ACAP, what is the ACAP, students? Well, the ACAP is the Alabama Comprehensive Assessment Program.
The Alabama Comprehensive Assessment Program, or ACAP, is broken down by grade level, and it's aligned with the Alabama Course of Study. It's administered to students in grades 2-8 in the spring. It's administered 100% online, so parents, anything you can do at home with your student to help them be prepared for that computer-based test would be helpful.
If you are in second through sixth grade, when you take the ACAP, you will be assessed in reading and in math. And if you are in grades fourth and sixth, you will also take the science portion of the ACAP.
So why are these scores important? Well, the scores provide students, teachers, and administrators and Alabama residents with information regarding student progress toward mastery of the ACAP and the state standards. So we're using this to determine our school's report card and where we rank compared to other schools in the district as well as other schools in the state. It also helps our district compare itself to the other school districts in the state. Plus, it's very meaningful for you because you get to brag on our success as a community member of Dayville.
Absolutely. So students, why is the ACAP so important for you? Well, it assesses your student knowledge of grade level concepts. Your teachers have worked so hard to teach you the grade level content that you've been learning all year. So let's show what you know. It guides instructional decisions that we make for you at the school level, and it provides information regarding your students' strengths and weaknesses.
So what is DES doing to help prepare your child for the ACAP? Well, there's a lot. There's Tier 1 small group instruction. There's Tier 2 small group instruction. There's Tier 3 small group instruction. There's an after-school program, a summer reading camp, and supportive materials like Education Galaxy that your students are familiar with, as well as ACAP practice test questions. Ms. Miller, would you like to explain a little more to the parents maybe about what our small group instruction is?
Absolutely. So students and parents, I'm sure you're familiar with Education Galaxy, Accelerated Reader. I know that you've heard about those things, and even Reflex Math. But those are all things that you can work on at home as well, not just during the school hours. But the ACAP training tools are things that your students have been trained on using here at school. It just helps them become more familiar with the things that they will see while they're taking the ACAP. More importantly, or most importantly, I should say, is making sure that your child gets enough sleep the night before each section of the test. And as always, please, parents, communicate with your child's teacher. There is nothing more important than the relationship that you have with your child's teacher when it comes to your child's school performance.
We all know that science and research has proven that attendance at school is so important. So please help your child be at school every day.
Be at school every day and be on time every day. Because if students are late, they will not be allowed to go to the classroom. Testing will begin promptly at 8 o'clock each morning on test days. Students must be in their classrooms and settled on time by 7:45 each testing day. So parents, please do your part and help us get students in the building and settled on time. And if you look on your screen, you'll see a link for ACAP practice tests. Parents, if you will, please practice these at home with your student. I mean, we'll let them know that you feel these tests are important, and I'm sure they would love to share this with you.
So when will all this testing take place? Second through third grade will be testing April the 11th through the 15th, where fourth through sixth grade will be testing April the 26th through the 29th. Those days are important because, as Ms. Miller said, we need your kids to be rested and on time and ready to go for those tests.
Students and parents, there are no secrets to success. It is the result of preparation and hard work. Let's ace the ACAP.
Thank you, Ms. Miller. Thank you, Ms. Chamness. I know that's a lot of information for students and parents, but ACAP is a big thing. So hopefully you guys are going to do your best on ACAP and show everybody just how smart Dayville Elementary School kids are. Well, that brings us to the end of another great broadcast of TNN Tiger News Network. And as we always say, Tigers travel to the top.